We've heard from many people critical of even the request for public cash to help pay for Casey Anthony's defense. But as West 2's Dave McDaniel shows us, many of the most notorious people in history had taxpayers funding their defense.
Nobody wants to end up at the courthouse either as a victim of a crime or as a suspect in criminal activity. But the law requires that if we do end up in court, if we're charged with a crime, we're entitled to a defense, even if we don't have a dime.
They've been having problems, too, on death row.
Serial killer Eileen Warnos, a drifter, had a public defender.
Guilty of both first-degree premeditated murder.
Troy Victorino, convicted and sent to death row for leading a beating rampage. He and others taking baseball bats to several victims. He had a court-appointed lawyer.
That's correct. It's the law. And you have to provide experts for them if they need them.
Jeff Dowdy defended Troy Victorino. He was appointed because the public defender's office needed help. His salary paid for by the state, just like a public defender. Ted Bundy, vampire cult killer Rod Farrell, all defended at taxpayer expense.
The law requires that you provide an adequate defense for that person. And in order to do that, you're going to have to utilize experts.
If not, the Supreme Court will likely kick it back.
And then you wasted all those time and resources the state attorney put together and all their resources they use, only to have the Supreme Court say, well, why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? You can't say, well, I didn't have any money. That's not a defense. They're going to reverse the case, and you're going to be right back to square one.
The man who opened fire at the Orange County Courthouse years ago, a biker named Crazy Joe, John Cooey, convicted of killing little Jessica Lunsford, all represented, with taxpayers picking up a good chunk of the tab.
You can't say, I don't have the money, it can't be done. The law provides for it. The Constitution provides for it. There's a due process issue. You have to defend that person.
What makes the Anthony case somewhat unique is she started with cash for private attorneys and ran out.
Coming up at 5, we'll look at the amount of money available each year to defend people who are accused of crimes. And we'll compare that to the amount of money set aside to put people in prison. Reporting in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.